Morning viewers, my name is Sprite. I'll be taking you guys for computer practice N6. We are going to do Microsoft Word. Our topic for today is columns, okay? So at the end of the day, you will be able to know how to create columns. You will be also be able to create three equal columns. You should be able to insert columns, break, and also you should be able to save a document, okay? Right, now what I want us to do is, I want us to do an activity from our computer practice N6 textbook. The activity is under Microsoft Word activity 4, okay? Now it reads, type the following document on a blank screen in MS Word. The font size is Arial 12 PT. Justification, it must be used. It must be full. Make use of the soft hyperlation function. Number two, it says, make use of the column function to create three equal width columns as indicated below. These are the columns, okay? If you check here, we've got column 1, we've got column 2, we've got column 3. These ones, these headings, they are only in column 1, okay? And also the last paragraph here, it is in column 1. Follow all the manuscript signs. The manuscript signs that you are given are these ones. Center, bold, 20 pt, uppercase, center, size 16, uppercase. These are our manuscript signs, okay? Then it says, save the document as immune in your folder. We are going to do that, okay? Now what we are going to do is, we are going to go back to our Microsoft Word. Bear in mind, it says, can you scroll up? Now, this is the text that you are having. This text is supposed to be in Arial 12 pt. As you speak right now, you can see that our text is in Calibri, body size 14. So we are going to change that. What I want us to do is, I want us to highlight our text starting from Immune Boosting Kit. So highlight, go down. Right, thank you. Now we are going to change it to Arial. We are going to change to Arial. The size, we are given size 12. Okay, right, thank you very much. We are done on that, okay? Now scroll up. This is our main heading, okay? This is our main heading. Our main heading is supposed to be 26 PT uppercase bold. But before that, let's first confirm these two. Now, let's go to our question. Let's go to our question. This is our main heading. It's supposed to be center, bold, size 20, okay, and uppercase. And then the subheading, center, size 16, and uppercase. So this one is not bold, but this one is bold. Center, bold, 20 PT, and uppercase. Right, let's go. Let's highlight our immune boosting kit. Right, we are saying size 20, bold, uppercase. Where do you capitalize this text? We can come here where it says change case. Click on the drop down arrow. You select uppercase. It is now in uppercase. Then the next one it says it's supposed to be aligned center. So this is how we are supposed to change our text based on the manuscript signs that you are given by the question paper. Okay, right, let's scroll up. Now we've got our subheading here. Let's highlight our subheading. Now our subheading is supposed to be size 16. Size is 16. Remember, it's not bold. Leave it like that. It's supposed to be uppercase. Where do you get your uppercase? Change case. Select uppercase. Alignment is centered. Right. This is how it's supposed to look like. Okay. Right. Now, let's go back to the question paper. So for now, we have done these two parts. Okay. We are now here. It says columns from this point forward, meaning we're supposed to have column 1 under green tea, we have column 2 under African potato, we have column 3 under spirulina, okay? So this is how we are going to do. Now, between green tea, African, these are column breaks, okay? From here again, going up here, is a column break altogether. So what we are going to do is, we are going to go and put our cursor before the G of green tea, where in our document that we've been doing, Microsoft Word, okay? All right, so scroll up, right. Now, we are supposed to create three columns from 1, 2, 3, and this one will remain one column. Scroll down a little bit so that we have our heading there, so that you can see our heading. Right, somewhere, not too much. This immune boost system should be here. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, right, so this is our document. Three columns. Column one is green tea, column two is African potato, column three is spirulina. Okay, now let's put our case up before the G of green tea. Okay, now after putting our case up, now I want us to click on where do we get our columns. You get our columns from page layout. Let's all click on page layout. Right, remember, our cursor is blinking before the G of green tea. Okay, right, so we are on columns, we are on page layout, want to create columns. We click on the drop down arrow of columns and wait for me then. Click on the drop down arrow of columns and wait for me. You don't use these shortcuts there, otherwise you use the shortcuts, then your document is going to be wrong. You select more columns. Okay, let's click on more columns. From more columns, remember the question paper says we need to have three columns. We are going to select three columns here. Let's select three columns. All right, from three columns, we are here. Equal column width, this is more important, okay? Equal column width, we leave it like that. Can we see where it says apply to? Where it says apply to, I want us to click on the drop down arrow here and we say this point forward, okay? Right, click on this point forward and we leave it like that. We've got where it says that new column. For now, we are creating the first column, so we don't actually use this one. You only come and click on OK. You only click on OK. Right, we are now having one column. This is the first column, green tea, all together. Now, our second column is supposed to start from African potato. Let's put our cursor here before the A of Africa. Let's go back to columns, more columns. Right, now we want to make sure that this Africa moves from where it is right now, it goes to the second column, okay, which is this one. How do you do that? Already we have explained, we have defined there that the number of columns that we want is three, okay? Equal width, we leave it like that. The most important part is where it says apply to. Can you see where it says apply to? You click on the drop down arrow where it says apply to, and then you select this point forward. After selecting this point forward, because we want to start column number two, therefore we are going to come in here and select this checkbox which says start new column. Let's click there, start new column. Remember, we are here, we want to start the second column, so we want this column to come and select that side. Okay, let's then click on OK. Right, what happens to our African potato? Our African potato moves to the second column. Are we together? Right, bear in mind that our green tea and African potato, they are parallel to each other. Okay, right. Now we are supposed to take this one, spirulina, and make sure that it becomes the third column. Okay, so what do? We are going to take our cursor and click right here before the S of spirulina. Go back again to columns. You select more columns. Right, for more columns. Already, we have told the computer that we need three columns, which is 100% correct. The equal width column, we don't tamper with it. Apply to. Right, where it says apply to, click on the drop down arrow and we select this point forward. Remember, we are on column two. You want to move to column three. Therefore, you will have to come back there and say start new column. This spirulina is supposed to move and it becomes to column number three. Then let's click on OK. How many columns do we have? We now have one, two, three. Now, these three columns, they are parallel to each other, okay? Right, now, we want to break these three columns and we go back to one column. Meaning, this table where it says these tables, it's supposed to be on one column. So what do? With that? We take our cursor and we put it right there before the T of these. Go back to columns, more columns. Right, remember now, we are done with three columns. We now need to go back to one column. So what do? We click on one. We click on one. Apply to this point forward. Now, when you are applying one column, you don't say start new column altogether. You just leave it like that. Don't select anything there. You come back here and you click on OK. This is our text altogether. Bear in mind that our green tea, African potato and spirulina, they are in bold. So what we are going to do is, we are going to highlight green tea, go back to your home menu, select B for bold, right, followed by African potato, bold, right, spirulina, B for bold. Now, this is how your document is supposed to look like. These are your columns, okay? Right, let's go back to the question paper. I want us to check something. You see this, how the document is. This is how we have done it, okay? All right, we've got our main heading, subheading there. We've got our column number one, column number two, column number three, and we have our text there. We are done. The only part that is left is to do what? Is to save the file as you mean inside our folder. Let's go back to our Microsoft Word. So this is how the document is supposed to look like. Now we are saving. How do we save? You click on File. You click on File, Save As. Right, Save As where? Inside our documents, under the folder John Jones. Right, what is the name of the folder? The file, the name of the file is called Immune. The name of the file is called Immune. Immune. And then you click on Save. Right, we are done. Thank you very much, viewers. That is Computer Practice N6 Activity 4 under Microsoft Word. See you next time.